Hi all, thanks a lot for joining in. I hope you are able to hear me and able to see my screen. Okay, so let's get started. Give me a moment. Okay, so thanks a lot, guys, for joining in. This is Rahul Arora, founder and instructor at Way to Automation. So we have a huge audience today. There are many students who are attending our Selenium, Java, Python, and API automation batches, and many external people who have joined today, especially to meet Sanjay Kumar from Selectors Hub. So this is going to be a great learning session where Sanjay will be demonstrating Selectors plugin and will show us effective way of working with complex locator strategies using XPath and CSS. So in case you are from automation industry and have worked on Selenium, APM, Protractor, Cypress, then you must have used XPath or CSS in your automation scripts while locating elements on the web page. And at times, some of you may have faced challenges while writing a dynamic XPath or CSS in order to handle complex elements. So Sanjay will tell us how Selectors plugin is going to make our life very easy so that we need not to invest a lot of time in building up complex XPath or CSS locators. So without wasting much time, I'll hand over the session to Sanjay and he'll walk through with his great stuff. And but before that, since it's a huge audience today, so everyone is on mute by default. In case you want, you have some questions or queries, then you can type it in a chat box. So there's a chat box on your GoToWebinar screen. So you can just type it in the chat box and your queries will be answered. And in case if anyone want to talk directly, then just type to unmute yourself, then we're gonna unmute you from here and then you can directly have a one-to-one conversation. So I'll hand over it to Sanjay and then we can get started with our session. Just give me a moment. Sanjay, I have made you the organizer and the presenter as well. So, you are on mute at the moment, so you can unmute yourself.
Hi, Rahul. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, perfect. First of all, thank you, Rahul, for having me here, and a very good evening, good morning, guys, those who are on the call. Hope you all are doing good. And today, this session is going to be really excited. And mostly, I will try to avoid the very basic thing which you already aware about. We'll see some of the things, the very fundamental concepts, and trust me, you will get the goosebumps about getting to know those scenarios and things that, oh, this was also possible. Oh, these we were doing wrong in a wrong way. So definitely this session is going to be very innovative and informative for you guys. And trust me, you will be saving a lot of time after this session. So hope this will be fruitful for all of you. And as Rahul already mentioned, if you have any query, please put it in the questions in GoToWebinar window. So there is an option type your question. So there you can type it. And generally I used to keep it very fast paced, but as we have quite enough of time today, So we'll go slowly. If whatever queries you have, you can feel free to you are feel free to ask. And let's get started. So I hope like all of you are from the like automation background and you have a little bit knowledge of automation. What is automation? Selenium, WebDriver, Cypress, or in any of the automation API or technology you are working in, this is going to be really helpful for you. XPath and selectors. The name sounds like very small when we write automation because there are big names like Selenium, Java, and automation framework when we talk about like automation. But actually, you won't believe like XPath and selectors are the backbone, you can say, and the most important part of your automation. Rahul, I hope my screen and voice is clear, so like I'm not just going.
Yes, Sanjay, we are able to hear you and see you.
Okay, perfect. Thanks. So like selectors and XPath are as important as the tires of a car. If you don't have good selectors, good XPath, your script will break in next run itself. So we will have to make sure that whatever XPath and selectors we are writing that are really good and stable. Because if they will not be good, doesn't matter how good framework you have built in, doesn't matter how good programming and all those things you have done. No, if selectors are not good, your script will break in like very first step. So we will have to make sure that we write the very stable and good XPath. And that's where our automation script used to be like good, considered as good automation script, good test case has been written if we have written the stable selectors. So when we write XPath and selectors, so generally let's say on google.com, if we have to write an XPath of this element, what we do, like we just right click and then inspect, and then this DOM used to open here, and then we start typing, right? So to get the XPath for this element, we have like lots of method in XPath, like very standard formula, double forward slash tag name, @ attribute name is equal to attribute value. And then there are like lots of other formulas for like one element. We can write n number of types of XPath. I will come to that, like what all types of XPath and how we can write that. And then similarly, like we have a lot of functions in CSS selectors as well. But can we remember all of these functions, like all the XPath function, all the CSS selector function? Can we remember all of them? Like in like we write the Java code or Selenium code in when you write in your editor, so you see that we used to get like these as soon as you start typing, we used to get all these as auto suggest. So do you remember, like if we ask you the question that do you remember all of these functions, like under driver what all functions are there? I'm sure like the mostly answer is no, we don't remember all those functions, because we are skilled people. We know that yes, how to deal with the things, how to write the program, how to do the programming, how to write the code. But remembering all the functions, all the API functions is like really difficult. So same goes for XPath and CSS selector. But till date, there was nothing that can help us that what all functions are there. So what we were doing, we were just like learning. We will just keep learning those things. In Hindi, we used to say that ratta marna. So what we were doing is that like we were just like remembering those things. Okay, there is a function, and whatever functions we used to follow, like if somebody is writing XPath in this fashion, in this pattern, trust me, he will be keep writing in this fashion only most of the time. He might not have explored this one. He might have not explored this one, not this one. Then there are more functions like normalized function, like just to use text functionality of an XPath, there are like n number of functions which can be written in n number of ways, like dot function is there, contains function is there, normalize space is there. So we cannot remember all of them. So do we have the smart editor like IntelliJ in case of like we write the Java, I mean any code, PyCharm we have for Python, for JavaScript we have WebStorm, so different kind of editor we were having. So why didn't we have the editor for selectors for writing XPath, why we have to remember all these functions. And most of the cases, we don't remember all of them, because generally we write the XPath in like, when we say that we should not use an, because I'm sure like you all of have heard that we should not use an XPath tool, we should write our own XPath. But when we say that we should write our own XPath, basically we are writing XPath here, like this way. And here you will have to remember like what all functions are there in XPath. What all functions are there in CSS selector? And trust me, nobody knows that what all functions are there. They just remember a few formulas, and then that we used to keep following. And just to just sake off like that, we will get failed in interview if we will use an XPath tool. I will come to that point. So here we have the smart editor for XPath and CSS selector, the very first smart editor selector sub. Now you can build your own XPath and CSS selector in less than 5 seconds without compromising learning skills. Let's see how. So if you have installed already selector sub, that's great. If you haven't installed, you guys can install maybe like, let's just first let me show you, and then we can take a 1 minute of time and then you can install it. So suppose here we have to write XPath for this element only. If you would have writing XPath here, the very first thing, like this DOM used to like used to go up and down. First of all, like if there are like more than one element matching, so here you just start typing, you will see that it used to give auto suggest along with the number of occurrences. So you will feel like it is like an smart editor, like you see this one here. When you write in your IntelliJ in Eclipse, there you get auto suggest. Same you goes for selector sum. So you see here the things has become very easy for you now, that you see you get all the possible XPath and selectors attribute functions. So at the rate, whatever attribute will be there for the inspected element, it will suggest, and what all possible things like contains and equals, all those functions it will suggest. And as you start typing here, you will get those values. As you will be typing, you will get or like if that will be there, then it will show them. Like you want class, it will give you that, and there you go. Simply you can complete your XPath very quickly. You will not have to copy the value, wasting time in copying the value or writing the anything. If you inspect any element over here, you just start typing for that, simply complete it. And so here we are building our own XPath, as well as we are writing our learning, as well as we are writing both index-based XPath or any kind of thing. You can done it here very quickly. And if you want to write CSS selector, it will auto start suggesting CSS selector like this way. Whatever you want, you can do it here. So it makes life very easy to write your own XPath, own CSS selector in a very simple way, and saves a huge amount of time. This is the very first smart editor. Like for any functions, anywhere you just go, you have to write XPath for that element, that particular element, inspect that element, selectors will help you with everything. You see that you will get all those functions, like dot function is there, contains is there, normalize space. I'm sure like many of you might not have heard about normalize space function is there. So these functions are really important. You will learn new things from here. What all functions are possible, because these questions comes in interview. People ask such questions, like what they will do, they will write this kind of XPath here, and they will ask you like, is this XPath is possible? Many times you say that no, this is not possible. Sometimes you say yes, this is possible. If you notice that there is an space here, if what interview will do, he will remove this space and he will ask you that, see, this XPath is here, this XPath is here, why it is showing zero? Immediately you might not be able to notice it, so he will ask you to correct this XPath. What you will do in that case, if you don't learn, if you haven't learned about, or if you haven't heard about normalize space, you might not be able to write that XPath. So normalize space is the function where it used to trim the value, like this text value. So whatever space will be there that it has trimmed, and now it will say that yes, that one XPath is matching. So basically, like how selector sub will help you to learn new things, learn about selectors. Basically, it is a guide. You just inspect the element, whatever information, whatever important thing thing will be there about that particular element which you have inspected here. You just inspect that element. Now start typing. You will learn automatically from selector sub. Okay, this is possible. This is possible with this. If I will write this kind of X path, there are one matching node. If I will write this kind of X path, there are 18 matching node for this one. If I write this kind of X path, there is a zero matching node. So the importance of showing this zero is that you should understand what all things are possible, what all things are not possible. Suppose in interview tomorrow, somebody asks you like this kind of, is it possible? So at least you can say, no, this is not possible. This is not possible. So those things you will learn from here. And you get that value here that whether it is XPath function or CSS, because selector sub is really smart. When you will start typing CSS, it will give CSS selector option, auto suggest. If you will be typing XPath, then it will give XPath option. So like this you have done, then it understand that, okay, this is XPath you are typing, this is CSS selector you are typing. So here you notice that it also gives dollar star cap functions, which are like really important. This is contains with, end with, start with. So all those things it gives, like if you're writing like this kind of CSS selector. So suppose if you have deleted this text and you keep it equal, then it will say zero matching node. But if you make it a star, you want to write in a CSS selector contains with, then you will get that by using this star. So selector sub will give you that those options, while like if you are not aware about those functions, you might not be able to learn that. So from here, basically you will become more smart in writing selectors and XPath, because you will learn, like basically when you start writing more code here in Smart Editor, what you gain, you basically acquire more skill, you become smart in writing code. So same does goes here. Like how do you learn new functions when you start writing code here, right? Similarly, like when you will start writing XPath selectors here, you will learn new things about elements, about web, about DOM, about locating the elements, about writing the XPath. So all those things you would be able to learn. Any questions so far? Let me just look at the window. I'm not sure. Rahul, can you just help me with this? Like if these are the questions?
Yes, I guess the last question was how to install selectors that Dheeraj have asked.
Okay. So, okay guys, so let me just show you how you can install it, and then we can go further. So
I hope Sanjay, you are able to see the questions and answer window, right?
Yes, I can see that. I got it.
Okay, thanks so much.
And when I'm making it at front, are you, is my screen is interrupting that with that?
Like no, my, I mean, audience will not able to see that.
That go to webinar window, right?
Yeah.
Fine. Okay, perfect. So guys, here you see that how to install selector sub. Just open selectorsub.com. And here you see that different browsers options are there, like Chrome, Safari, Firefox, as Opera. So whichever browser you want to install, you can install it. So I'm sure like most of you guys want to install it on Chrome. So just click on that Chrome. And here there will be add to Chrome button. So click on that. It is already added in my, that it is showing remove from Chrome. Then after that, one more pop-up will come, accept that, and it will be installed. After installing, you will see that selector sub will not be visible here. It will be here like this. You will have to pin to toolbar. So I'm just taking 1 minute of time. You guys can install it and then we'll continue. Meanwhile, I will take, I'm taking other questions which are there in the window. So you guys can install it. Could you please explain how that star works in selector? Yes. So star is basically contains. It is in CSS selector, star is used to contains value. So whenever there is like, let's say we want to write a CSS selector which has the attribute value contains, substring of attribute value. So here if you go for any element, if you take, and here let's say we want to write in CSS selector area current. like this we have written. If we delete the say let's say some string value of page like this, it will be zero matching node. But if you will add a star here, then it will be one matching node, because this star is basically contains width. Likewise, dollar is there. So dollar is like start with value and end with value. So if you keep it dollar like this, then if you remove some value which is like basically end with value, if you see here, let me show you these functions. Ends with value, starts with value, contains with value. So if your value is ends with like this, so suppose you want to find out all the links which has area current value ends with GE, then you can use dollar like this, it will match. If you remove this, then it will not match. Similarly, like if you want to start with, like let's say PA, page was there, and if you want to get those links which has area current attribute as PAG pack, so if you hit enter like this way, this will not find any matching node. But if you add cap here, then it will find one more one matching node. So basically this function, these are the function dollar, cap and star, and this you will learn from selector sub. Like when you will start typing over here, you will start getting auto suggestion in auto suggest those value. And these are like really important functions. Another good thing, like whenever you want to learn about those things, so if you will be having a selector sub, there will be tips and tricks in here, so that you can learn about here from here, like FAQs under those and tips and tricks. Here you will get those all those more functions about tips and tricks. So those things are given here in the website as well. I will show you all of them. I hope this this is clear now. Star function is clear. How to create text selector in CSS? Text selector we cannot create in CSS selector. Text is so that's the one of the best feature of XPath, that XPath support text and CSS selector doesn't support text. So that is the reason that XPath is so famous and it is considered as most flexible. Like we cannot use this text in CSS selector. I hope Abhishek, that's clear to you. Can we get recording of this session? Rahul, I guess yes.
Yes, the session is being recorded. I'm gonna forward the recording once the session is done.
Yes. So Abhishek Chauhan, I guess I have answered that question. Text is doesn't support CSS selector. How selectors have works in Chrome? So yes, this is how I'm showing in Chrome. So this is how it works on Chrome. And you will get more functionality as you go on. And there are a lot of features, so I will show you or show all of them. And guys, after installing it, just restart your browser or whatever tabs are already open, refresh them. And if you are not able to find selector sub in your DOM, like when you inspect element, you might be able not be able to see like this here, it elements tab. On the right side, you will see a couple of tabs, but here selector sub is not visible. So it will be the last tab here. You see two arrow icon are there. Selector sub is the last tab, or you can expand it here to better view, so that it will be visible like this one. After installing, what we need to do, you just need not to do anything, just refresh the like whatever tabs are already open, or restart the browser once. And here selector sub logo will not be visible on the top right corner on the toolbar, so this you will have to basically pin here, pin to toolbar, then it will be visible. That's all you need to do. On work computer, the selector sub is blocked. No, so not selector sub is blocked. Basically, it is blocked. Your company has blocked the extensions, browser extensions, not selector sub is blocked. So what you can do, like most of the company has already unblocked it. So if you want, like you can just request to your manager or your admin team that you want to use selector sub, and please get it unblocked. And here are the privacy policy with which they will unblock it. Like you can show them that the publisher has disclosed that it will not collect any user data, and selector sub is the most secure plugin. It runs only on your local. So this, if you will show them, they will unblock it. Many of the company has already unblocked. So basically some of the companies keep blocking the extensions, because some of the extension like not, they doesn't feel the extensions are safe. So for that region, you can show them that this, that it has been declared from the Google Chrome side that it is the secure plugin, doesn't save any user data, doesn't steal any kind of data, and it runs only on your local. So you can get it unblocked. And as well as on the Selector Sub website also, it is mentioned that it is the safest plugin, doesn't have any server, anything. It runs only on your local. I hope, Abbas, that helpful for you. So do we need to reach out to admin and security to ensure it's safe? Yes, you just tell them that they, I mean, basically what they used to do, they run a, some kind of code from their end, and they will diagnose this plugin, and they will find it like, okay, this is safe. They will automatically, like on your request, they will approve it. Sanjay, sometimes when there are multiple selectors available, how do we know which would be the best? Okay, so whenever there are like multiple selectors available, how do we know which would be best? So it comes from the basically from the experience you will learn this. So let me just turn on this feature now. So Selector Sub also gives the auto suggest. So when you will see that there are multiple selectors available here, which one should we use, whether we should use CSS selector XPath? So yes, CSS selectors is of course preferable more than XPath, and it is given on that is the region that you see in selectors. So CSS selector is suggested as first one. So you can use CSS selector, and over the time with the experience, you will get to know that which attributes are more stable. So if you feel that attribute values, whichever selector has more stable attribute value, then you should go with that. If you feel that ID is unique and ID is there in your, if you find ID with your element, then always go with ID, name, then like if name is there, then go with the name. ID is first is ID, then name, class name. So whichever, like apart from XPath, if any other selector is available and you feel that that is stable, then go with that. XPath, keep XPath as a last option. And whichever most, like most of the time you will have to think, and I mean with your experience and accord as per your application, you will have to take this decision if which attribute is stable. So it's all always about like which attribute you can use, and which is the like intelligence in writing XPath is like choosing the attribute, which attribute could be more stable. What about the frame? How can find the frame? Yes, Manju, I will show that how does it helps with the frame. It's amazing innovation in selectors of, about frame and shadow DOM. That I will come, so that you will see. Not able to see. I hope Gaurav, you are able to see the selectors of now in DevTools. It will be like last sidebar tab as I showed you here on the right top right corner in the. Auto suggestion are not working. Don't try it on blank tab like this. There should be a website. There should be a URL like google.com. So make sure you have open google.com, not trying on blank tab. Dheeraj, I hope now you will get it. Or if you have not refreshed after installing the page, after installing selector, if you are trying on existing open page, then please refresh your page. I asked that extension in my company. Okay, so then let me know the advanced selectors of advanced selectors of XPath. Sure, Abhishek, we'll come to that. Also, let me know the dot is equal to functionality. So yes, when there will be text, and then in that case you can use the like dot function. Can you speak slow? Okay, sure, I will try. How can we find the iframe? I'm coming to that. I guess these questions are repeating now. Okay, good guys. So I hope you all have installed it, and we have covered a good number of questions. Now moving on, how do we write the selectors for shadow DOM elements? So before that, let me show you something here and explain the functionality of selectors some more. So here you see that this was the editor mode first when we have seen like this. So here you get the editor mode, here you start typing in getting the selectors. So So this is like very simple. If you doesn't if you are like beginner or someone you who want to learn and who want to write own XPath, they can keep this mode. This is off. Like turn on. So if you want to turn on the auto generated selector, you can turn on. There you will get all the functionality and lots of amazing features and auto generated selectors for every inspected element here. So you see here that whichever element will be inspected here, you will get all possible selectors for that. So here you see that relative CSS selector, relative XPath, name, class name, JS path, absolute XPath, tag names, all possible selectors are giving it here along with their occurrences. And if anything will be like any attribute, it will feel that it is dynamic. It will suggest you that this is dynamic, class looks dynamic. Then in that case, you have attribute filter here. If you want to generate without class, you can uncheck this. Now it is generating without class. So these are the good options. Like it will suggest you that this XPath looks dynamic. You uncheck the class, or if you feel that no, class is not dynamic, it is static, then you can keep it like this way and you use this XPath in your script. So this is really good feature. And if you want to generate XPath with any of your specific like attribute, in that case you can pass the attribute and name here in like selectors hub. That way it will generate, like here it is generating with area label because we have passed the area label value here. And but you want, let's say you want XPath with item scope, this attribute item scope, that you can pass it here and press enter. You will see it will generate XPath with your attribute. So this is really helpful. And now if you inspect any element, it will generate, if that attribute will be available, it will generate with that attribute. Otherwise it will go with some other attribute. And to understand more about the functionality of like how selectors are using the attribute and what are the preferences, you can go to selectors of YouTube channel and watch there that how attribute has been, what are the preferences of attribute in selectors hub. So that from there you would be able to learn. So this helps a lot, this attribute functionality. I hope you got this. Like whichever attribute with attribute you want to generate XPath, that you can choose it here. Like if it is generating with ID, you don't want with ID, you can uncheck this. It will go with something else. So this is helpful. Then there are more functions, like let's say you currently we are getting this XPath. What we can do, we will copy this XPath. And what you do, like you go to your script here and driver, you type like this, driver dot find element by dot XPath, and this is how you paste the value, right? But what if like every time you have, you will have to type this, lot of time waste, right, typing the similar command. So in that case, selectors have has really good functionality. You come here, there's a set driver command. You can set the driver command and you get the complete thing. So what you have to do, wherever XPath is there in your command, replace that with XPath value. Press enter. You see that you got the command. Now you copy this value and come here, paste this. Amazing. Now you can do whatever you want. You want some other element, let's say you want certificate. You see, you got that. And here, whatever you want, you click, that you can do. And it's really quick. See that you got the XPath, CSS selector, whatever, whichever command you want, you can take this and come here and paste it here. So this will, this way it will help you a lot. And whenever you doesn't want, you can keep it off. And this command could be anything, like in your framework. I'm sure like many people doesn't write like this. They write like this, find element by dot XPath or something like this. So in this case, what you have to do, you just have to keep the XPath value wherever you have written XPath in your command, and then you can use this. This is very helpful in case of like whenever you have to generate the page object model or something.
So send you one question here. So this feature should work irrespective of you're using Java or Python, because in Python we use find underscore element. So it should work.
Absolutely. Yes. So like, absolutely, thank you, you asked this question. So that's why like I showed any command. Your command could be anything, whether you are using Cypress, Selenium, Java, C#, .NET, anything. You just have to, you see that? Let me just type random thing. It could be anything. Wherever you have written XPath in your command, like this, just replace that XPath with XPath value keyword and press enter. Your command will be ready. So I guess that command which you are saying, find underscore element, like this.
That's great.
Yeah, and this command will be used. Notice that you need not to set this command again and again. This is one time effort. If you close this, and next time when you will open SelectorServe, that setting will be saved in your local, so it will come up with your setting. You see that now, and whenever you doesn't want, you can keep it off. You can keep it off neat and clean, and whenever you want again, you just have to, now you just have to click on this, that command will come. You need not to set this command again and again, only once. So I hope this is helpful for all of you, and if you have any doubt, feel free to ask on this. And this is really good, like in case of you are writing Cypress in you're using Cypress, so I guess cy.get they use, and here they write this CSS selector. So you have to just, in place of CSS selector, you just have to type XPath value and press enter. You got that, like this. And this you can directly copy and use it in your Cypress script. So this way it will helpful. So that is the reason it is not, SelectorServe is not dependent on any technology, any automation API framework, whatever you are using, it will support. And whenever you want, you can keep it off. So this is very simple. So we have seen filter, we have seen auto-generated code. Then we have more advanced feature, like if you want to generate the XPath for multiple elements, because like we have seen that when we were suppose on this website, let's say we want platform, docs, blog, forum, download, all these headers, we want these value. In that case, what we will do, we will inspect them like this, and then we will turn on the command as well. Let's say we got this value, we will copy this, we will go to our editor and paste this like this, right? Again come back, again inspect another element, get this value, copy this value, go back. But here we are doing one by one. Can we get all of them like in single shot, so that like we will not have to waste time back and again? Yes, we have this. There's a button, click to generate automation code or multiple XPath, click on this. Now inspect all these elements, you will see the magic. And now keep inspecting which all elements you want basically. And you see, if you notice on selector sub tab, this all is happening. And suppose you want with command, you just turn on this. And here, let's say you want with not this command, any command, whichever you want. Let's say driver.find element. Whatever it could be, I'm just keeping it. And here you go, your code is ready. You can click to copy all, go back to editor and paste it here. Yes, you're done. This you can also export in XLS file and keep it there. And here you see that you will get all kind of possible selector for every element. So this is really fast and super fast. Also, there's another good feature here. If you see, notice carefully, because many times when you are writing page object model, you don't write X command like this, right? Mostly we write key value pair, where you give, for every XPath, you give a name with which you refer in your automation script. So this is a tricky part basically. Like, let's say for this platform, I want to give platform keyword. So here what you have to do, replace that with wherever you write the selector label or selector name for your XPath, replace that with selector name. Like this, and then press enter. So now you see that, if you notice that, copy this value and come here, you see that for platform this is XPath, for docs this one, for blog this one. So basically, if your command is something like whatever your command is, like for XPath, this was the command. So we have replaced the XPath in wherever was XPath, we have replaced that with XPath value. Similarly, wherever you have written your selector name for this XPath, replace that with selector name like this. And then press enter, you will get all of them. If you ever got confused, there is a suggestion here. If you hover on that, you will get to know that what command you have to replace with, and then you can go there. Also, if you get more doubt, you can click and watch this video tutorial to learn more about this functionality. This is really helpful and huge time saver for you guys. So this is how you generate multiple XPath and saves a huge amount of time. Then like many people doesn't want XPath with single code, because you notice that by default selectors have generate XPath with single code, but you doesn't want with single code, let's say. So there is an option now, you can generate XPath with double code. You click on this, now it will generate with double code. So if you now if you will explore inspect element, you will see that it will generate with double code. So this is helpful, like a small feature but really helpful. Then we have a debugger feature. This is really amazing innovation. I will show you guys this one. So if you have any question, let me take that. If you have iframe or shadow DOM question, we'll take all of them later, because I'm going to explain all of them. Okay, debugger mode. I'm not sure where I have left last. Okay, maybe now I will take the question at the end, because the same questions are coming, which I'm going to show you guys. So we have seen like many features. Now let me show you this debugger feature. There are like many elements today which we cannot inspect. For an example, if you go to goiver.com, and here if you type something from a destination, let's say Delhi, if you inspect this element, try to inspect this element, as soon as you right click, that used to disappear. So this is really tough to inspect such kind of elements. And even if like you make it appear them and you try to inspect from here, they disappear. Really challenging to inspect that drop down element, such these drop down elements. In that case, neither we are able to inspect nor we are able to write these selectors for them. Then what to do? Trust me, like I have done a lot of surveys on that. Many people say it's like it takes hours of time to inspect such elements. Some say it's like 5-10 minutes. Minimum 5-10 minutes it used to take to inspect such elements. And some says it is impossible to inspect such elements. And trust me, like yes, those who are not expert in JavaScript, for them it is like almost impossible only. But not anymore. Selector Sub has made it possible to write selector for such elements. You just click on turn on debugger, click on this. Within 5 seconds, you have to make that element appear here, and you will see that it will hold it here. And now you would be able to inspect this element, as well as you will be able to generate the selectors from Selector Sub. Inspect this element, you see that XPath is also generated for this element, and we are able to inspect this Toronto, Canada. Anything, everything, you will be able to inspect it here, and the selectors will be generated here like this. So this is really helpful. You can inspect and generate selectors from Selector Sub. And if you want to write your own selector as well, as that you can do it here. When you will be typing, it will be suggesting the number of occurrences along with their function suggestion. But when you will press enter, so there is only one limitation here, because debugger is on. So when you will press enter, it will not show how many matching nodes, but there you already getting from drop down that how many matching nodes are there. So that will help you. But when you will press enter, it will not show how many matching nodes because debugger is on. Simple. So this is how this debugger innovation has made things possible to inspect such kind of dynamic elements, which disappear immediately when you click anywhere. And once you are done, you click on that execute. So after that, it will like complete the script. So we have covered all of them. And this is the reset button. Let's say you have done lots of settings here, and you have set the command, you have set it here, something you have unchecked, and at any point of time you feel that you want to reset everything to default selector sub, there's a button here. Click on this, it will reset everything by default, and then you will like start fresh. So it will be like everything is reset, all the commands, attribute thing. So it will come as a default mode, in the default mode. So that's what that button is. Now let's see what all another amazing things are there in selector sub. How to write selectors for shadow DOM elements. Writing selectors for shadow DOM, it was always impossible before selector sub. Actually, it was not possible at all to verify selectors for shadow DOM elements using DevTools easily. And that's where people like, for beginners, it was like nightmare. And people, sometimes even beginners, just give up. No, we cannot automate such elements. Because if you inspect this element, this input box, if you notice it here, that this element is like immediately you won't be able to understand that this element is inside shadow DOM. Shadow DOMs are basically DOMs in DOM inside DOM, and these are the partial DOM basically. So if you have to write selector for this element, what you will do, like you inspect this element, you will just immediately start typing here --/ input, something like this, right? But it's showing 0 of 0. You will be surprised that input is there, but it is showing 0. So it was like impossible to verify and write selector for such elements using browser dev tools. With the very first thing, let me tell you guys the concept that shadow DOM doesn't support XPath, and XPath doesn't support, you can say, shadow DOM. And how do you get to know that this element is inside shadow DOM? You will have to look at the DOM if this is inside any kind of this shadow root. So it is not inside this, it is not inside this, it is not inside this, it is inside this shadow root. If you notice that this input is inside this shadow root. And that is the reason that we cannot write XPath for this element. And in fact, like browser DevTools doesn't support shadow root. Shadow DOM, if you copy this XPath here and paste it here, it is showing 0 of 0. So which is basically wrong. Now, XPath doesn't support shadow DOM. We learned that CSS selectors support shadow DOM. So we can not write XPath. We will have to write the selector. So ID is there. So we can write hashtag ID, right? Hashtag input. But still, it is not showing anything for this. So basically, let me tell you that shadow DOM elements cannot be verified from here, the search bar of DevTools. There are ways to do through console, but they are like really complicated, not easy one. So this is really, really difficult, but not anymore. Selector sub has made it easy, really easy. You just open selector sub and let selector sub do everything. You see that it tells you that this element is inside shadow DOM. So you learned about that. Okay, this is inside shadow DOM. Then it gives you the information. You see that the relative CSS selector for this particular element, XPath, this element is inside shadow DOM, and for such elements, XPath won't support. So you learned about that. Then JS path, then tag name, everything it gives you. You just inspect that element, it will give you all the information about that particular element. Good thing about it is you will get the complete script about that particular shadow DOM element, because I'm not sure if you are aware or not, shadow DOM elements, you cannot just copy this CSS selector value, go to your editor, and you cannot write like this directly, like driver.findElement by.css selector and access that element. No, you cannot do that. This is not the right way to handle shadow DOM element. You will have to first access that shadow root host element, then you will have to traverse inside that shadow root access, then you can access this element. And this is where you get the script from the shadow DOM, from the selectors for this shadow DOM. So here you get the information that this element is inside the shadow DOM, and this is the script for that. And if you copy, you just copy this script, complete script like this, and go to your editor and paste it, it will work like a champ. I will show you guys this one. So this helps a lot and makes you guys understand about the shadow DOM, how to handle shadow DOM elements. This you have to just like enter like this, and whatever you want to enter the value there, that you can do and execute this script, it will work like a champ. This is written in Java and Selenium. If you are using any other technology, any other framework, that you can do. Simply, basically, what you need this CSS selector as well as this host value, host selector value, like which is the host for this element. Then you whatever like functions you have written, that there you can replace with this one. Basically, you need this. So those this I'm telling to those guys who are already accessing shadow DOM and writing the code, and they have the framework. So basically, guys, you need this, and rest you can replace as per your framework. Otherwise, if you are writing simply Java Selenium, then you can directly use this code. So this is really helpful. This was, trust me, guys, this was never possible, never possible. The thing which you are doing in just like second, it used to take just this much piece of code used to take whole day. And big thing, let me show you. Nested shadow DOM. That was seriously, that was a nightmare. If you get like an element which is inside 4, 5, 6, or 10 shadow DOM, it will take like whole day or maybe 1, 2 days. If you guys want to try, just look at this URL, sandbox-sponsor.pointsvillay.com. Try this URL to enter the value on this field manually if you guys want to just check how much selectors will help you. So this, take this website. I'm just pasting it here. I'm not sure if I can send it to all. Yes. Take this URL if you can, and try to enter, try to write an automation script to enter the value in username and password, and see how much time it takes for you guys. Okay, now let me show you for this field if we have to write the enter some value here. So this is the element, this is again inside this shadow root, and if you look at the DOM, this is one shadow root, then again it is inside this, this again inside this, then keep on looking at this, this again inside this. So there are like so many shadow DOM, it is like almost impossible to manage manually to write selectors and XPath for each shadow root, and then XPath selector for this element, then all the shadow root host. No worry, just open selectors up. Whatever you would have done in entire day, 1 day or 2 day, that you can get in just second. Inspect that element. You see that it is telling you that this element is inside 4 nested shadow DOM, and these are the shadow root host selector, and this is the complete script. If you click on this copy button, go to this editor and let me paste this. So you see here, I have just opened the driver browser and the URL. After that, I'm just pasting that complete script what we selector sub is giving. And here, let's say this is a username field, and here we want to send some values. Let's say we want selector sub. Now let me execute this, and you see the magic. You will see that, notice that it will open that website, traverse through all the shadow DOM, and enter the value in username field. You see that it has entered the value in username field. So this is how it helps a lot. And trust me, if you will try it manually, it might take whole day for you to write this piece of code, because it's really complicated to verify all the shadow root host element and then selector for the element which is inside multiple shadow DOM. Not easy thing, not at all easy thing. So this is how it helps you in writing selectors, verifying shadow DOM elements. standard talking about the SVG element, moving to the SVG element. SVG elements are like special types of element again in web in DOM. So if you inspect any element which is which you don't know, like let's say you doesn't know about this kind of element, so what selectors will help you that here let me close this and open it again so you can make it you'll be able to understand. Like let me inspect this element first, now open selector sub. So if you see that, notice that this element, if when we inspect, this is showing XPath, CSS selector and other stuff here, right? Everything is fine. So this is normal element, normal web element. You can directly write XPath, nothing is special about that element. But when you inspect this element, this is SVG element. Selectors will tell you that this is SVG element and there's something special about this element. So basically SVG element, XPath, standard format of XPath doesn't support SVG. Like when you write double forward slash SVG, actually this is a wrong invalid format for SVG XPath. So you will have to be like extra careful. SVG elements are vector elements in the web, which is used to like donate these kind of icons which developers use. So this is the right format of SVG XPath. When you start typing double forward slash, you see that it gives you the right syntax for that. And now this is not unique. So there you can like in selector sub, there's a feature that you can use the index feature as well. Selector sub support indexes. Put the cursor in the beginning. Just type open square, open parenthesis. Selector will suggest the unique XPath with index for that particular element and press enter. Okay, so this is SVG element and it also gives you auto suggested XPath for SVG element. Click on this, you see that. And now if you inspect any element, it will give you the SVG element. SVG, you see this path. Child, for child there is a different format, child is that this one. So this is how you can write the SVG XPath, SVG selectors for SVG element. Talking about the frame and nested iframe. Frames are like really important part in to identify whether this element is inside iframe, because in general what we do, we start typing like this double forward slash input and type is equal to text. We never check for this if this element is inside iframe or not. First we will execute this script, then we'll realize that oh, this script is breaking, then we look out, start looking out, okay, it could be inside iframe or it could be something else, right? As soon as you inspect element, you don't look for that if this element is inside iframe or not. So here selector sub will help you a lot. You just open selector sub, immediately you will get everything. Selector sub will let you know that this is the iframe, it is inside iframe, it is inside frame. This is the frame XPath inside which this element exists. And this is the selector, these are the selectors for this particular inspected element. So simple, it's very simple now. You just copy this XPath, go here in your editor. You can just like switch to command whichever is you are using, switch to this frame, then you can directly perform action on this. So it's really easy. But what if iframe within iframe, there are multiple iframes. In that case, how things will be really complicated. Now this element is inside this frame, then this frame is inside this frame. Suppose there are 10 iframes. In that case, what you will do? It will become really difficult, right? To write all the iframe XPath and then element XPath. In that case, don't worry, selector sub support that. Only selector sub has made it possible. You see that this element, it is telling you that this element is inside two nested iframes and these are the iframe one. This is iframe one XPath, this is iframe two XPath, and this is XPath for that inspected element. So this is amazing. And it also support command. If you turn on this command and here if you type that driver.find element, then you will see that iframe commands will convert into this web element command. Press enter, you see that you get complete thing. Now you can copy this, go back to your editor and paste it. That's all you have to do. So this is how it supports the iframe, nested iframe, and it's all really, really easy and really good and saves a tremendous amount of time. Now, another great innovation. Can someone tell me what's wrong in my selector? Because it happened a lot that when you write XPath like this, you have written, and this is a really long XPath, right? Suppose if you have missed something like this and you copy this value, let's say, and paste it here, you're verifying here, it is showing 0 of 0. Would it be easy to identify what is wrong in this XPath? I'm sure like no, answer is no, because you can, I mean, with the naked eyes, it is hardly, I mean, it is difficult to identify there is that square bracket is missing. But if you paste that value here and press enter, it will let you know that close square bracket is missing. Then you will look where it is missing. You will identify, okay, somewhere it is missing here, and then you can verify. If anything is missing, single quote is missing, it helps you with that, those kind of information. Like in interview, if somebody asks you, like they have written this kind of XPath, whether this is the right format or wrong format, you might not be able to immediately answer, but with the selector sub, you would be able to learn these things, like hit and trial, you keep doing that. Here it is telling you that add tag name after forward slash, this is invalid XPath. Suppose it is written like this, it will tell you what is wrong, what is not possible. So that all things you would be able to learn from here. Like what is missing, what is right, XPath doesn't support shadow DOM. If you will try to do those things, all those things it will tell you. Before this, like let me show you, I'm sure like many of you have this question. Before I go to your questions, let me show you that how to write XPath with how to write XPath using Axis, because many of you want to know that, and many of you use that. Let's say we want to write XPath for forum with respect to docs. In that case, how can selector serve will help you? Definitely selector serve will make it really, really easy. So when we have to write XPath for forum with respect to docs, the approach will be, first we will write XPath for docs, then we will find common parent for both the elements, then from that parent we will try to jump to this forum, right? So let's first inspect docs, and here first we write XPath for docs. We have written XPath for docs. Now we have to find the common parent. Hover here in depth DOM, this UL is the common parent, inspect this. So this docs was the element, right? So here you see that when you will start typing here and type ancestor, it will give, start typing ancestor, it will giving immediately auto suggest. So you see that when you will hit enter, it will tell you that, okay, this is the common parent for this forum and docs. So we got the common parent with respect to docs. Now we want to write the XPath for forum, inspect that. And here you just start typing, that's all. So here you see that we have written XPath for forum with respect to docs. So first we have written XPath for docs, then we try to find out the common parent, and then we written the XPath for this forum. Now here, if you want to write XPath for forum with respect to blocks, you just replace this docs with blog, and here we written the XPath for forum with respect to blog. With respect to blog, if you want to write XPath for docs, change this to docs. XPath is written. So this is how like you can quickly build the XPath with ancestor with the time, I mean, because of time limit, like I may not be able to explain each and every functionality here, but you can just like as soon as you start typing here, it, if you, there will be like anything following siblings will be there, it will show you, like let's say this element, if there will be following siblings, it will show you that all following siblings, ancestor, child's parent, whatever possible, you just start typing, it will suggest you those things, whichever will be possible. So this is how you can write the XPath with Axis. Now before coming to why selectors are, let me take your questions guys. Now it's been quite some time, I keep speaking, I'm not sure where I left. previously. So do we need to reach? Yes, this we have answered. Manju Verma, I hope like now you got it clear that how you can write these selectors for frame and iframe. Not able to see that was done. Auto suggestion, Dheeraj, I hope that auto suggestion is working now for you. Don't try it on blank tab, try it on google.com. And then after installing, make sure you have restarted browser. I asked that extension in my computer. I added that extension, I guess. Let me know the advanced selectors of XPath. Yes, I guess you have seen that. Can you speak slow? Iframe is done. How to use? I'm not getting output after locating to Google text box. Anilima, is it working fine now for you? I'm not sure where they will reply. Just that, like, make sure that you have you are not trying, guys, on blank tab. So this is blank tab. This is not google.com. And if you will try to inspect this element, which many people does this mistake, if you will try to inspect this element, this is not actually web application. This is just the HTML of the blank tab of your browser. This is not web application. Extension works for web application, not this kind of like browser HTML. Either they will work for the local files or for the web application. So make sure that you have opened the google.com. There is a URL in the address bar. There should be a URL. Now if you inspect this element, this will work. Now if you will type it here, this will work. So make sure that you have opened google.com, not trying on blank tab. Yes, I reopened it. I hope that is working now. I'm trying on selector sub. How to handle dynamic drop down by using selector sub? So yes, so one I have showed you guys that how you can handle these kind, how you can inspect such kind of dynamic drop downs. There is another kind of drop down where is a sub menu is there and then elements are there, like this kind of drop downs are there. And like when you try to inspect these elements, you are not able to inspect them. You see that we are not able to inspect such kind of drop downs of like which are there in flipkart.com if you see here. So these kind of drop down which you are not able to inspect, but you are able to right click on them, there selector sub will help you with the right click menu option. There you can directly copy the XPath from here, copy relative XPath, and this you can paste it here in selector sub, and you can see that like what all values are matching or not. As well as here from you see that there are options to customize context menu. So this you can customize here, so that way it will help you. And now if you right click, and you will find all of them options. So such kind of dynamic drop down, you can get the selectors like this way. Show the advanced XPath and CSS. So okay, when you are saying that, so advanced XPath and advanced CSS, I don't understand what does that mean. Let me try it this way. That if you try to write XPath for any element, so one I guess like that is the one you are looking for, that writing XPath with access. So that I have showed you. Another is that this one, if you look at this, what selectors have generate the XPath and CSS selector, that those are really, really optimized. If you see that this is the element here, input box. Here you see that for this element, this is the immediate parent, then this is the immediate parent, then this is the immediate parent, and then this. If you try to write XPath for this element manually, let me show you here, double forward slash input, then multiple times you will have to inspect this element. And then you see that this name is equal to email, let's say, @ name is equal to email. So you see it is showing 2 of 5. Then again inspect this element, and then what we will do, like look for the parent, right? This one. So let me copy this value. @ class is still 1 of 5. Again inspect this element, see, again we'll go one more label up like this, copy this XPath, and you will see that how long XPath we are writing here. This is still 105. Then we'll go one more level up. Let's say this one. @ class is equal to this one. So you see that this is a long XPath we are able to write for this element. But if you notice that what selector sub has generated, selector sub has directly, if you inspect this element, selector sub directly connected this input to that unique parent. And it has, like, let me copy this value, what we have typed and what selector sub is giving. Just paste this. You see that this is the long XPath which we have made. What selector sub has done, selector sub has removed these value in between and connected this child to this parent directly and made it the XPath for this one. And this is the CSS selector. You see? So I hope this was the answer. Is it possible to use debugger mode while inspecting quick disappearing element like dropdowns? Yes, I have shown you that debugger feature. Can you please show me how to install it on Mac? So I'm using it Mac only. So it's very simple. Just go to selectorsub.com, whichever browser you want. Like, you just click on this and go. And if you want to do install on Safari browser, so please follow this video tutorial how to use it on Safari. On Safari, it is a little bit different, so that you can follow. Rest all it just simply like install. That's it. While I'm trying to download selector, it asked me to me extension. I'm still confused how to download. Guys, it is very simple to install selector sub. Let me just show you. There's no extra science in that. I'm just removing it. You have to just click on add to Chrome, add extension, and that's all. It is added here. So you see here, after installing, you have to open google.com, and here it will not be visible. That you can pin to toolbar. It's very simple to add selector sub in your browser. And after that, after installing it, you will have to like refresh those tabs which are already open in your browser to make it work, or simply just restart your browser. That's all you have to do. Okay, I hope like now you guys are able to add the selector sub in your browser and it's working fine. Just make sure not trying on blank tab. We can right click copy XPath also, right? Yes, you can do that. How it know the attribute is dynamic? It will suggest. See, we cannot, nobody can tell us that ABC123 is dynamic or not, right? It could be dynamic for you, it could be static for me. For an example, if you right click and inspect here, and you see that the values which are here, like this class value, this name Q value, and this class value, this pretty much looks dynamic, right? PR49AE, this looks dynamic. But if I refresh the page, this is not dynamic actually. It is stable, it is a static value. So selector sub, what selector sub does, selector sub tells you that with this alert icon, that class looks dynamic. Now it's up to you whether you, because your application, you know it better, that which attributes are dynamic, which attributes are static. So you know that according to your application, you can decide that whether you want to generate XPath with class or not. So if you know that this is dynamic, then you can uncheck that it will generate with something else. Else it will, you can keep it checked. Let me copy this value and refresh this page. Now paste this, you see that it is still working. So this class is static, but it looks dynamic. So selector sub will suggest you. Audio is not coming. Ankit, I'm not sure like if you are able to hear or not, because it's been long time now. Rahul, my voice is clear?
Yes, Sanjay, it's okay. Pretty much there.
Thank you. How this will work with dynamic elements? So this I have just shown. How to write selector sub tab adjacent to inspected element console? So you cannot, because good question actually. You cannot put it like beside console. So this is actually best view that you have elements beside here, this one. Browser doesn't allow to add this, I mean this kind of tab here, So this is actually the best view because you get the elements tab axis here, DOM axis, and you got the selectors of both. We cannot put it this one here, because if you will put here, then in that case your elements tab will go. Then you will have to switch back and forth like this to view DOM. So this is best view, and there is a limitation from the browser side. We cannot put this selectors of tab here. We can put that here, but in that case this DOM will not be visible. So that is the challenge. But here you are able to see this one, you are able to see this one, and here this is the best smart editor, so you can write and build your own extra as well. It's coming down. I don't know what you are saying. Perfect. Can you show the multiple once again, please? Yes, there's a very simple one, I guess. Sridevi, that there's a multi-selector generation button here. You just click on that, and either you have to start clicking on the DOM elements, or you just inspect the element whichever you want. It will start generating. So this you can do that. It's very simple. And at any point of time, if you miss anything, don't worry. There's a detailed video tutorial. You can anytime go and watch on Selectors of YouTube channel. Here is a link, as well as you can search on YouTube or Selectors of. You will get there. There is a link here, as well as in the footer as well. You must be getting it here. Like here, you will get this video tutorial. Watch the detailed video tutorial, and the link is also given here. There's a way to lock it. I don't know, what do you mean by that? Lock the screen from where you open debugger. I was not able to see. So there's a button to open, just turn on this one. So on the right side you will see that couple of buttons are there. So this is the debugger button. Turn on debugger button is there. Click on that. So please suggest on li handling. So I don't know, what do you mean by that, but if there are li elements, like multiple li elements are there, so that also you can handle it. Like you can just start writing XPath if there are li elements. So simply you can write that. I don't know, like there could be multiple ways to, I don't know what kind of handling you're asking. So sometimes people write the common XPath for all the li elements, so that you can write and then traverse through that to get all the values of li elements. So I guess that you are asking. When I turn off auto selector and turn on auto selector, I am not getting XPath for any attribute after this. I reset setting, but same issue. When I turn off auto selector and turn on auto selector, I'm not getting XPath for any attribute. XPath for not for any attribute, XPath for elements first. The concept is XPath is always for elements, not for attribute. I reset setting. So if you turn on this one, turn off this one, you will not get the auto generated. If you turn on this one, you will get it auto generated. Make sure that you have opened the right website. Try it. If you still face issue, feel free to connect with me offline. I will show you. Screen is freezed. Nothing is coming. Abhishek Chauhan. I guess not sure if for everyone that is happening. Abhishek, please check your connection. How we know that this is shadow DOM? Selectors will let you know that this is shadow DOM. This is quite helpful in that case. You are going so fast, Sanjay. Okay, I sorry about that. How to find an element if the pie chart SVG element has the same address for all the pie? So pie chart, we cannot write the selector. If SVG elements are there, that we can that selectors will help you with that. Rahul, is my screen freezed for you as well, or is it
no,
going fine?
It's fine. I think it's our old message. It's working fine now.
Okay. Will selectors help to create dynamic XPath where the attribute change every time? Yes, selectors will help you with that. Will it help with canvas element? No, canvas element it will not support. How to find an element if the pie chart SVG? I answered this. What happens when selectors stops working for sometimes? If there is a very huge DOM, in that case it may be slow, but it will work for sure. You can sometimes, if your system hanged or something happened in your system, like browser, if you have opened, like 50, more than 50 tabs, and in that case, like your browser itself goes slow down, then you might have to close all those tabs and then open, reopen. But Slack itself will work. Go to leave now. Thanks, Rahul. When we will try to find elements using SVG element. Means whenever you require, what was the difference in the previous page and this page with URL? I don't know. Do you have any video tutorial separately? Yes, there is a link for video tutorial in the YouTube channel. You can search for Slack to Sub channel. Any limitation of Slack to Sub? Good question. So there is only not, I would say, the limitation of Slack to Sub actually. That's a limitation of W3C standard actually. So when there is a closed shadow DOM or closed shadow DOM or iframe from the different source, that's where selector sub, not only selector sub, none of the extension would be able to support region because we cannot access closed shadow DOM. So if you look at this, this is a closed shadow DOM. While if you look at this one, this is open shadow DOM. There are two types of shadow DOM. So when this this is open, then in that case selector sub will work. But if that will be okay, so this is how what happened, like when you install selector sub newly and doesn't refresh the page, that's how. But other once refresh, that will work. So you see that this element is inside open shadow DOM, then it will work. But if it will be inside closed shadow DOM like this, then it will not work. But it will let you know that this element is inside closed shadow DOM, which is inaccessible. So for such element, it will not work. So that it will help you with that. Likewise, if there is iframe from different source, then in that case also it will not work. But those will be like really, really rare scenarios. So you need not to worry about that. How do we identify ng locators for Angular web application? You just inspect those elements, it will work for them. How to locate the current word population on the this one? You just inspect those element and it will work. That field is dynamic. So you will have to look for any stable element actually on that element. So here, how to locate the current word population? I guess this is the question you are asking from the Naveen's Selenium challenge. So if there is any stable element or stable attribute is there, then in that case, you would be able to inspect that, otherwise not. So this is the main counter. So what you have to do, you will have to write the XPath for this and then you can get the text or for this one. So write XPath for this element like this. So this is the XPath you can use and then get text of this. So at that particular time when you will fetch that value, you can get that value for that particular time frame. And there is a way, I will come to that pro tip. I have that separate slide for that. So I will show you something special. Is it possible to capture captcha? Captcha, you can write the XPath for captcha, but the value, that's a different thing. Like in the example in mobi.com, how user can set the selector hub in context menu when user can make. You just right click and set it there. It's still a student just curious, not sure. It's coming below elements tab. Some websites are unable to inspect. Is there any way to write the XPath or CSS for those? Yes, that's possible. You can just try it. If not not working, please let me know. How can we able to read the capture value at the login page using selector sub? A selector sub will help you to inspect the element and generate the right XPath, not the like value and all that you will have to check by inspecting them. How to change XPath tag to SVG iframe shadow tag? How to change XPath tag to SVG iframe? No, I don't understand your question. Sanjay, when is your next online seminar? I want to know. I would like to join. You will have to keep following me on LinkedIn, Twitter. Maybe you will get to know that. Can we use XPath count function using XPath while? Can we use XPath count function using XPath while dealing? with yes, you can use that. It's up to you. Is it helpful while working with web tables? Yes, it's not working. Please try to refresh the page. For example, this one. CrowPath is still working. So I have stopped development and support on CrowPath. So I would request you all of you that please upgrade to Selector Sub. Selector Sub is the new reality. You will not get any further update. It's been like almost 9 months now for me that I stopped working on CrowPath. That's outdated now. So move to Selector Sub, upgrade to Selector Sub. You can install CrowPath. It's up to you. And there are like a lot of amazing innovation on Selector Sub. AngularLocator will work with Selector Sub. Yes, they will work. Have you had explained something related to blank page for google.com related to finding element? Can you please repeat that? See, none of the browser extension will work on the blank tab. You guys, means many of you are trying on this one. You are thinking that this is google.com, but this is blank URL. There's no URL, blank tab. Is Selector Sub a free extension or plugin for any browser? Yes, it's absolutely free plugin for all the browsers. Can you paste YouTube link for this session? Yes, that Rahul will share later. Okay, perfect. We have covered all the questions now. Let me show you something amazing. Why Selector Sub? This is really important. And I would really request like you all look at this one. And especially Rahul, you should I would request you to have this one.
So, okay, sir.
We always keep saying, like, in fact, like few years back, I also used to say that we should not use an XPath tool. We should write our own XPath. And we also say today as well, this saying is there, but those who came across Selector Sub and the innovation, they have changed saying it. That saying changed now. Because what happened, whatever we were doing it in the past, that we were doing it wrong. We were saying that we should write our own XPath. But do you know that, like after saying that, that we should write our own XPath or we are expert, I know how to write XPath, I don't use any XPath tool. But we all are using XPath tool, which is a browser dev tools to write and verify our XPath, isn't it? We don't write in Notepad or in directly here on editor. Are you, any of you are writing directly XPath here? No, right? We all write XPath here. But is this the right way to write XPath? Is this the right platform to verify XPath? Actually, no, this is not the right platform to write XPath. Because this gives the string match as well. If you see that, it clearly says that find by string, selector or XPath. So browser DevTools is not the right platform to verify XPath. This was just a coincidence that we were getting till date. We got the right number of matching count, but this is not the right platform. If you see that, suppose this is a very frequently asked question in interview, how many links on this page? And what people does, because interviewed, not everyone ask you that to write the complete script and all. They will just give you the laptop and will ask you that how many links on this page. And many people does this way, /A201, there are 201 link on this page. And that's where interviewer says that, okay, thank you, tata, bye bye. Because he knows that your concepts are not clear. This is not the right platform. You see that /A, this string is matching. This is not XPath matching here. There are not 201 link here. It is matching the strings. If you would have written the XPath as well, like any XPath, if you have written, if that XPath is matching more inside iframe as well, in that case, it will also show that matching element. So for an example, if you write XPath for this element, let me write /div here and add the rate class is equal to, what was that, container something, this one. You see here it is showing 1 of 6. But you know that for that particular element for which we are trying to write the XPath for this container thing, this is actually unique XPath for this element. But as this is showing 6 matching node, you will keep trying to make it unique, isn't it? but you will never notice that this is unique XPath for this element, while this is giving a wrong information region, because when you verify XPath here, it gives all the matching counts which are there inside iframe, outside iframe, and everywhere. That is where this XPath, this element XPath will break, and you will keep wasting your time. Now let me copy this XPath value and put it in selector sub and verify. You see that it is showing one matching node. So this is the right count. This is the right platform, standard platform. I'm not saying, because it sounds like that I'm praising selector sub because I'm the creator, but anybody else if will be giving the demo on this, then he can make it better. That this is the right platform. Selectors Hub is meant to verify and write the selectors. While browser dev tools, this one search bar is not the right platform. If you hear, we were trying to get all the selectors, all the links, double forward slash A, it is showing 201. If you put it here, you will get the right count of elements here on this page. Double forward slash A. If we type it here, 1 second. After adding what I did. 1 second. I guess I just. After adding, I guess I didn't refresh. Double forward slash A here. There are 65 links on this page. While if we verify here, double forward slash A, it is showing 201. So basically browser dev tools, as you guys have seen, that this is not the right platform to write and verify your XPath. But still I found people that writing XPath here and showing that this is how we write the own XPath. We always say that we write own XPath, but after that we have never discussed what does that mean by writing own XPath. We were always using a tool, but in a wrong format. So make sure that you write your XPath and verify your XPath in a right place. And in fact, like if you verify your CSS selector, suppose you have to verify a CSS selector through CSS selector, like CSS selector for anchor tag, A tag, this is what you will write, right? Here you see that 3177, you will never be able to verify. But if you write CSS selector A here and press enter, you will get the same number of counts. So suppose someone asks you in interview or somewhere that get me all the links in this page using CSS selector, will you be ever able to verify here? No, you can verify here only in selector sum. So that's where this is the right platform. This was the biggest myth in our history of like automation or web. You can say that people think that DevTools provide the right number of XPath and CSS selector match, but no, DevTools doesn't provide the right count of selectors match. Another myth, when DevTools shows zero matching nodes, it is not 100% true. So this is the fact actually. When you will see that there is a zero matching node, that is not 100% true. If your browser DevTools shows you that zero matching node, that is not right. Like for this element, if you right click and copy the value of XPath, or let's say CSS selector from here, and press enter, it is showing 0 of 0. This is not right. This is wrong. It is showing. If you verify this here, press enter, it is actually one matching node. So don't trust on DevTools what DevTools count it is showing. Like if you inspect this element, even if for the wrong count, it shows the zero matching node. Like if you have written wrong XPath, like this one, if you copy and copy this XPath value here, it is showing 0 of 0, but actually this is invalid XPath. So browser DevTools, if DevTools shows zero matching nodes, it is not 100% true. DevTools doesn't generate correct XPath for all the web elements. So if you see that, notice that it is generating this kind of XPath, browser DevTools, which is a wrong format. So DevTools doesn't generate the, because many people think like we can right click and copy the XPath value from browser DevTools. But actually that doesn't generate the right XPath value of SVG, and we have seen that this shadow DOM case, so there it breaks. So basically what I'm trying to say you guys, that please understand that browser DevTools is not the right platform. This was a myth which we have followed in the past because of due to lack of innovation, because nothing was there like selector sub. And now as we have selector sub, so please understand and learn these things from the selector sub, that what is the right count, what is, how to verify, how to write the selectors. Security, absolutely secure plugin. It runs only on your local. It doesn't save any user data, doesn't steal any user data, doesn't have any server. It runs only on your local environment. Does it slow down? No, not at all. It is just less than 250 KB in size. So doesn't make any performance issue. It might be like if sometimes you feel that your system got slow or something, make sure that you have not opened any other like multiple traps and all. It doesn't slow down. Request you all that, because not everybody yet aware about selector sub, so please share it, blogs, article, tutorial, anything you can help it, that will be really appreciable from my side and whole community. This is absolutely free product, no license required to use. In fact, I have left my job and it's been almost 9 months. I have left my job and working full time on selector sub and for community. You guys are running selector sub, so if you feel that it is helping you guys, it is helping you in your job and your learning and business, please be patron and support selector sub. Even if you can offer me a coffee per month, that would be really helpful for my bread and butter. Here are some of the selector sub achievement. It won the Indian Achievers Award for 2020. It is being used in 130 countries just in like such a short span of time. Became number one XPath and CSS selector tool in all browser store. It appears like as in LinkedIn profile, skills in LinkedIn profile. Yes, of course, you can also add it in your LinkedIn profile. More than 40,000 active users. Developers calls it lifesaver. Everybody, almost everyone suggests to use this one because it is the standard platform to write in verify XPath. Huge thanks to all the test, all the sponsors of selector sub. I have already shown you guys, and this is the only plugin which is available for all the browsers. Right click, I have showed you that. That's a good tip for you guys to save more time. Pro tip, yes, there is something really amazing on selector sub which you might have never learned about that concept. But before that, can I request you guys, just I will take a 1 minute of time. If you guys feel that that selector sub is going to help you a lot and you learn something, it's my humble request. Out of this webinar, I'm not gonna get anything. Just open selector sub here. I hope you all have already added it, and give a 5-star rating and rate this. Anything you can write, good or whatever you feel there about it, that will be really motivational for me and will give me energy. So I'm just holding for 1 minute. I'm drinking water. Please help with the 5-star rating here. It will help others to know about this tool, and it will help me to get motivation. After that, I will show you something really amazing, which you might have never learned about that concept. And this is really, really amazing. You will learn something new. So I'm just holding for a minute. And it's my humble request, please share it like with your team and other people, because still people are not aware about selector sub. And guys, I'm like one, this is just one man army. I'm alone working on selector sub from the like designing and then testing, development, marketing, end to end. This is just one man army with a huge community support. So this is all you guys are helping and motivating. And at any point of time, if you need any help from me or you have any question, connect with me here on Slack channel. Also, there's a like, if you will become a patron, there's a special benefit, like, because when you will be writing here the selectors and verifying selectors, when you will press enter, you will see that your view will be hidden, like you are not able to see all the matching notes, all the like anchor text, which all anchor texts are there. These are hidden behind this and your view is interrupted. So here you will get the access of this close button. If you will become patron, I will share a key with you guys, unique key for all the patrons, and you would be able to hide this banner, like this ad footer banner will be hidden. So be a patron and you will get a unique key with which you can hide this one. I hope you all have rated selector sub and supported me. I'm just waiting. This is 9:43. We'll start at 9:44. I will show you guys these pro tips. Those are really amazing pro tips, and you might have never heard about those concepts. So those will really help you a lot. Till date, you have heard that we can write the XPath using attribute and attribute value. We can write XPath with text. But have you ever heard or read about other way around that we can do something more on that? A concept and very basic fundamental concept. Like sometimes people ask that those who used to do a lot of web scraping and all, they used to write the XPath in such a way that they directly get the value, text, everything through XPath only. So I will show you something really magical. Holding on for another 30 seconds. Sorry, guys. Out of 69, I got almost 19 reviews. Out of 69 attendees, 19 people has rated it. Thank you so much, guys. I would request others as well. Thank you, Sudhir. Okay, so let me show you guys. Those who haven't rated, I would request you please rate it after, like, you can after this webinar. XPath based on attribute presence. Like we have seen that we can write the XPath for any element if there is an attribute or like any attribute is there. Let's say here on Google search, let me make it a simple example here. You see that we have written XPath for this element when there is a name, right? When there is this attribute value, like name is equal to this, class is equal to this. Now, if I ask you that, get me all the input on this page, let me write this way. There are two input with this one. Get all the input which has the name. In that case, like this way, if we write, there are 9 input. Now you have to get me all the input which has the name attribute. So that, how can you do that? You just forward slash and at the rate name, press enter. So there are 9 input in this page which has the attribute name. How many input tags are there which has attribute class? There are 5 elements. So this way you will make it difference. Now just press enter. You see there are 9 input elements. I hope this is visible. Let me zoom in. So you see that there are 9 elements matching. But if you want all those inputs, so you see here, like class is equal to this one. This input has class. This input has class. This class, there is class. There is class. There is name. This input doesn't have class. So now you have asked me the question that get me all the inputs which has class. Okay, so we have to remove these inputs from our XPath. In that case, how we will write this? You will have to forward slash and add the rate attribute name class. Press enter. Now these are 5 classes of those this input. So this is how you can write the XPath based on attribute presence. and get those elements based on attribute presence. Get me all the input based on their presence. So this is how we can write the XPath based on the attribute presence. Like it is telling us that there are five input which has the class attribute. How many inputs are there in this page which has the ID attribute? 0. How many input text which has the name attribute? 9. Like that. Suppose on this page, if you have to, like, that question is very frequently asked question, that how many anchored, how many broken links are there on this page, right? And how many links are there which has the href value like that? So double forward slash a and forward slash at the rate href. So there are 65 links which has the href, so which is correct. And actually, like, whatever numbers are there of link, they should have href. So this, there is no broken link and everything is fine on this page. So basically this is how you can write the XPath based on attribute presence. Get the attribute value through XPath. Now you see that this is basically giving you the attribute value. By this is the XPath to get the attribute value. And now you see that these are 65 matching elements is there, and get me all the links value. So these are the links value, and this is how you can get the link value. So this is the same pattern you will have to follow. Double forward slash a tag name, double forward slash tag name, and then forward slash at the rate attribute name, and this will give you all the attribute values. So these are all the links. So suppose somebody asks you how many, get me all the links value on this page, what you will have to do, like let's say on linkedin.com somebody asks you, get me all the links value, href link value, what you will have to do, just go to selector sub, and this selector sub only will support, not, you would not be able to do it here like double forward slash a and forward slash at the rate href. No, you will not get the value here. But if you type copy and paste it here in selector sub, hit enter, you will see all the links value here, whatever is there in, like, what LinkedIn has used. So these all links value will get it here. XPath based on text availability. Yes, we can write the XPath based on text availability. Like, we have to get all the, let's say, header H3. There are two H3 header on this page. One is this, which has this header, another is this. And now we have to write it on based on text. So what you have to do, double forward slash H3, forward slash, like after XPath, you have to do text. If both H3 will be having text, it will show two elements. If there are more, then it will show more. So likewise, if you go here and suppose if we have to get double forward slash H1, there is one. And if you have to get the text or based on text, then you can hit enter, it will show you H3. There are three elements. You want the text, just type text and press enter to H3 with the text. And these are the text value of those H3. So you can fetch the text through XPath. So basically through XPath, you can get the attribute value and you can get the text value as well through XPath. With that, thank you so much, guys. We have covered a lot. Thank you so much, and really appreciate Rahul for your for having me here and giving me the opportunity to interact with all of you guys and share my thoughts and knowledge. And I hope, like, this really helped you a lot, and this will help you. Again, I would request you guys, those who are in business, and if it is going to help you in your business, please support SelectorSub to keep it running free forever. And this is absolutely free and community product. You guys can connect with me and follow me for further updates on upcoming innovation on SelectorSub. Please share SelectorSub, do rate it. And with that, thank you so much. And let me just have a look on the window if you have any question. Thank you so much, guys, for rating it. Ginny, how to rate from where you have added selectors hub, there on the review tabs is there on Chrome Store, there you can rate it, as well as in the selectors hub tab itself. There is a review star here, that button, click to add rating. So from here itself you can add. How we can post our suggestion or question to you? Yeah, feel free to connect with me on here on Slack. So if you just click on that Slack channel link, join me on Slack, and there you can any suggestion or anything you can suggest, as well as GitHub link is there, so you can raise your issue or suggestion there. I'm very active over there, so I take all the suggestions. There are a lot of suggestions. So if you go to like selectorsup.com here, if you look at the change log, you will find that there are many people who have suggested like features and many features. In fact, like if you see that, you will find it here that who has suggested which feature, and you will get the like their name as well here on the change log. Like you see that this issue has reported, their name will be there, like thanks to Gaurav Khurana for suggestion this feature and all, so that you will get it there. And like you see that this is one feature I haven't shown you guys, like when you type it here, like this auto suggest are coming. Sometimes people doesn't want to see this auto suggest, so in that case you can turn it off, like turn off this one. Now you will not get any interruption. Some people just wanted to type their own XPath, so that way you can type it here whatever you want, you will not get auto suggest. So this feature was suggested by one of the user, Gaurav Khurana. So yeah, appreciate. This you will have to use the Selenium to get. How to find broken links, you will have to write it separately. Thank you Dina. Thanks you guys, thank you. I could not catch all the lectures as it was so swift. Sorry about that. Yeah, you will get the like a video tutorial recording of this from Rahul, so please watch it later, as well as I would request you that, I mean, because we have to cover a lot in this session, and yeah, even though I mean this was 2 hour session, it still we couldn't cover a lot. So you can watch this, follow this video tutorial there on Selectors Hub channel, as well as like you can follow Rahul's tutorials as well. So you will learn more about it, and yeah, this recording will be available soon. So you can later you can just check it. So I hope that will help. And thank you so much, guys. Again, like my humble request, please share Selectors Hub, and if you feel that this is helping you and in your job, please donate and support me. And yeah, this will be really helpful. Rahul, anything you wanted to add? I'm just pretty much done from my side. Yeah,
thanks Anjay. I mean it was indeed a great session, and thanks a lot that you have taken out your time to deliver this valuable information. And I personally like the debugger, the set driver, and the shadow DOM feature, which is actually going to save a lot of time while writing automation scripts. So these are some of the best feature I found. And it's really a great tool I myself have used in my training, but not yet explored all these great features that you have covered today. And I will like always recommend others to use this while working with XPath in CSS.
Yeah, thank you so much, Raul. Yeah, that's really great.
Sure.
So guys, I guess we have pretty much covered everything. So thank you so much, guys. Thank you everyone for your time. And if you have any question, feel free to reach out to me on Slack or any of the social media platform. Recording will be available, Rahul, on any YouTube channel.
Yeah, do you have? I'll share it with everyone.
Sure.
So with that, I mean, we are good to end the session, and thanks a lot everyone for joining, and thanks a lot for your patience. Hope you have enjoyed the session. So I'll share the recording soon.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Sanjay.
Thank you so much, Rahul. Thank you everyone. Bye bye. Good night. Have a good day.
Bye.